on the perimeter of the site. It's got to provide essentially a retention feature. It's got to provide a public safety characteristic. It's got to provide an aesthetic and historic honorific kind of perspective. So we have to do a number of things with that wall structure. But really, in terms of heritage piece itself, what the character defining element refers to is that decorative cast iron fencing that sits on top of it.
Thank you for that. In regards to the trees, if we are required to remove trees, what size trees are we planning to bring in? What size trees can we plant to replace those? So what would this do the height? And there's the breadth of them as well. And in addition to that, how fast will they grow? For what the species that we're planning to plant, how fast will they grow? I'm not sure why people are laughing at that question. Maybe they all know, but I'm not a tree expert, so I'll ask the question.
So I'll start, and I won't be able to look into everything, but we can go and purchase trees with a 6-inch diameter. And we won't plant them now. One issue with planting something that size is that it takes 5 or 6 years just for the root base to really plant itself again. Or we can go in and plant a 4-inch tree, and it would end up in 10 years' time, we'd have to grow that older tree. So we can plant something fairly significant. It's not like we're going to plant a 50-foot tree, but we can plant something with about a 6-inch diameter.
And typically, how tall would those trees be?
That's something. It's all going to depend on the species. Something to come back with.
Okay, so maybe we can follow up and get a sense of that. And I'd also like to understand the growth pattern of those, so that I get a sense of for future generations how soon we expect to recover that tree cover. And then in regards to, we've had a lot of questions about trying to re-engineer and the wall and saving parts of the wall and saving, re-engineering the tree, how we work around the trees. I assume you'll bring costing for all those as well, because I would ask that you do. Obviously, a key component of our deliberations here is we want to look at what we can do to mitigate the impact, but we also need to keep in mind what costs of doing that. That needs to be something that's terrible for the residents of the city, so I want to make sure we do that. And I think that covers the question I have.
Thank you, Councillor Keenan. Councillor Chase.
Thanks very much, Your Worship. I do like to thank the body of public opinion that has come forward, not just the people who came out and expressed their opinion very passionately at the Development Committee meeting on the 26th, but also those that expressed their opinion to the council in the interim, both for and against the proposals that we've put on the table. And I'm also very proud of the effort that our staff has made. I think it would be, it's insufficient to say that this has been a completely consuming initiative, but I think our staff have risen to the challenge, and I look forward to the report that the staff will be bringing back as a result of the questions that we've received. I do have a couple of questions, though, and most everything that I might have otherwise touched on has been touched on by my council colleagues, but so I'm going to be very succinct. I'd really like to for us to re-examine one of the features that we have intended to, or we stated that we wanted to include in this, the revitalized Officer Square, that being the whether we need the water feature, that's one, and also the whether the stage feature, which I think has some advantages, but it also has some disadvantages in terms of the Vista view architectural design, if you like. Whether that in fact can be a portable stage, that would meet the needs that the Harvest Jazz and Blues, for example, use the portable stages in their events, and they seem to work quite well. It's just a question as to whether a portable stage could be used in this facility when it's required and removed when it's not. also have the advantage of being able to be moved to other sites in the city, you know, where there is a periodic need. So I guess I'm questioning the fact whether we need the permanent stage as it is, and also the water feature, something some call the splash pad.
Thank you. That'll come back in the reporter. You're looking for some answers tonight.
Well, if there's something that the staff wishes to run, I did wish to get to have this place marked.
Yeah. Ken or Dave, you want to make some comments?
Perhaps I'll deal with the water feature, and then Mr. Seabrook can deal with the stage. And I think, I think council will obviously, in the fullness of time before we report on this project, have an opportunity to look at all the features and make a final decision about what features are going to be within scope to proceed and which ones are. I think the water feature is one of those pieces that's perhaps the most misunderstood. And I think, in part, it's misunderstood perhaps because it's not been put in the context of a lot of the public engagement. And when we were doing public engagement on the revitalization of the square, one of the things that we heard quite frequently was a concern that Officer Square was not very family-friendly, and in particular didn't have a lot of facilities that would attract the interest and attention of younger children. So that concern led to two elements being proposed in the plan. One was the children's playground feature, which really speaks to the fact that in the downtown core itself, the area bounded by Brunswick Street to the river, there really isn't an adequate piece of children's play infrastructure in the downtown core. And then the other piece was not to try and recreate the Willamette Park Splash Park, but recognizing that it is a space that gets heavy summer use in very warm conditions like we've been experiencing for the last week or two. And a small feature that would allow people the opportunity to cool down is a feature that is very common in urban parks across North America. And I think probably just about everyone in this room has been to one of those, both small and large urban parks in cities across the continent, where a small feature like that is common to help provide some respite from the heat, at various times of the year. So really, two reasons for that. One is trying to respect the fact that the space needs to provide utility for people of all ages, and then also trying to respect the fact that, you know, in the summertime, in the middle of the day, when we're dealing with Cavalcampians and Chief of the Guard and all kinds of both formal and informal events, the opportunity to have a place to cool down in significant heat is of benefit. And now I'll turn it over to Dave to speak to the stage question.
Thank you. I'll just add a couple of comments on the water feature, because I think there's also, when it gets translated as a splash pad, people reference Beaumont Park. This really is something with no above ground features. It's at grade because we want to be able to take vehicles across it when it's not in use. So it's an at grade feature with maybe some jets that might come up, be triggered by either motion sensor or a physical foot sensor or something the kids could play with. But it's not imagined as great daisies coming out of the ground water jets the kids can fire around. That's not the feature that's envisioned there. And as a matter of fact, when it's not on, if we were to look at it, it would just look like a hardscape flat surface. You wouldn't really know it was there. As for the question about the stage, I think Councillor Jason and I over the years have talked a lot about the community's overall need for a portable stage. And I've thought a lot about it from the overall community need for portable stage. I haven't yet convinced myself, based on the user groups that I encounter on a day-to-day basis, that the investment would be worth it, that there's enough movement of the stage around. And the other challenge is that the mobile stages that we've looked at, the primary company that provides them, come in three basic sizes, and each of those user groups wants a different size. So it's very hard to pick one that works for everybody. So that's one thing. In terms of putting a mobile stage into Officer Square, that's certainly an option that we could consider. I think those people that are concerned about the look and feel and respect for the space as a National Historic Site, I gotta say that I think that you would probably, given that it would largely stay there for the summer, because we have Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday concerts now, basically, it would be permanently housed during June, July, August, at least, perhaps into September. You would largely have skyline. It would be your perimeter of Officer Square, and you'd have to evaluate whether or not a architecturally designed permanent structure versus a mobile structure, which would have greater aesthetic value, which is why we lean towards going to an architecturally designed stadium. As you know, we engaged one of New Brunswick's most prominent architectural firms, Acre Architects of St. John. They put a lot of consideration, they're very sensitive to heritage. Obviously, we weren't trying to mimic heritage, we weren't trying to make the stage look like faux heritage, but we were trying to make it complementary to the space, and that was, again, the primary consideration moving forward with the stage. So I think it's up to, you know, when we bring all options forward, I think it's up to council to decide what their desire is there on that front. But I think the aesthetics of the square may be better served with a permanent architecturally designed stage.
Okay, thank you. No further questions. Councilor Grant, you wrap it up for us.
Yeah, thank you, Your Worship, and thank you to staff for the information you gave us, and you all for to comments and suggestions and your opinions on what was asked at the public meeting. I think one of the biggest things I heard too as well at that meeting is we issued renderings, and renderings give an impression. And I think a lot of people who talk to me would like the details. And I think it's important that once you bring everything back, and once this council decides the options and what they want, where they want to go with this, that we get the details. Once we get the details, then we go back out and we let people look at the details and comment on those. So there's one back. Staff to figure out if that's a process and how that might take place, but I think it's all really important that the detail design, as we get to those decisions, gets reflected back with the public for the comment before we make our comments. Thank you. Okay, thank you, Pastor Randy. Thank you, Council and staff and the people in the gallery for sticking the note. I see the numbers going up a little bit, but not much. It's we appreciate you being here and your concern and engagement. And I thank the staff for the input that you gave us tonight. We'll look forward to the staff has had some time. I know everybody would love to have even more details tonight, but believe it or not, there's other things that we're working on too, other than this one project. This has been time consuming for a lot of people. It's very important. But we have a lot of other things that are going to the city too, and staff, and we have so much time. So we'll get a report will be coming back in due course, and we'll take the next step then. So thank you, everybody. We're going to take a 10-minute maximum break now.